AgDay Weather, brought to you by AGI Nico. AGI Nico dryers have an average of 1 to 2 pounds heavier test weight per bushel than screen dryers. They can also save you 30% on average in fuel savings. That's money in your pocket. Visit aggrowth.com/Nico for more information.
So as we looked at earlier, we do have a snowpack across portions of the United States and up here through Canada. As we go through the next couple of days, this low pressure system is going to bring down the cold air, combine it with the liquid water and create snow. That's a long way of just saying it's going to snow through portions of the United States. Let's go ahead and put this into motion. And you see snow coming down right over that snowpack that we looked at earlier, but then continuing into Minnesota, Wisconsin, northern Michigan. The interesting part of this is that it's going to be a combination of a low pressure system creating rain and snow. This is all the way through Monday of next week. So next Monday, it's going to be a combination of some rain and snow initially, and then on the back edge of the system, some lake effect snow, Lake Michigan, and then back up here into the UP as well. Michigan Tech, they're starting to see some lake effect snow from the system. So it's not all going to be from a low pressure system. It's going to be the combination of the low creating the lift in the atmosphere, and then lake effect creating the other. And there's also going to be some snow down here as well. If you've ever been to Snowshoe, West Virginia, that area, some higher terrain snow coming down for those locations. As for the jet stream, so what's going to happen is we got that low pressure system supported by the jet stream, 30,000 feet in the air. And we're going to actually see a shift back to the warmer here to the west. And you can see a very big amplified ridge developing off the west coast. It won't last all that long. And as we transition deeper into November, December, and January, they won't see as big of amplitude with our troughs and our ridges, which means that colder air is going to settle back in across the United States. Rather than seeing these big shifts in the temperatures, it's going to start to get normalized a little bit into the winter season. But that's what fall is. Fall is all about that transition from the summer to the winter. The jet stream on Monday, pretty quiet as this system exits off to the east, but back here to the northwest, you see that right there, that's going to be the source area for our next low pressure system. The colder air starts to ride back in from the northwest, more of an Alberta clipper with this one. So the cold air won't reach as far south as what we're going to see with this first initial one. So again, that's that next thing that we're going to be watching, and that's going to be coming up on Thursday. As for that overall forecast, Roswell, New Mexico, mostly clear, breezy day, high around 72 degrees, a low of 35, no aliens in sight. Sharon Grove, Kentucky, rainy day, clearing Friday, and East Dorset, Vermont, mostly sunny.